The U.S. Navy commissioned USS Vermont, SSN 792, the 19th Virginia-class attack submarine, on April 18, 2020. The traditional public commissioning ceremony was canceled due to the current situation. The U.S. Navy commissioned USS Vermont administratively and transitioned the ship to normal operations. Acting Secretary of the Navy James E. McPherson said, "The Virginia-class fast attack submarine will continue the proud naval legacy of the state of Vermont and the ships that have borne her name. I'm confident the crew of this cutting-edge platform will carry on this tradition and confront the challenges of today's complex world with the professionalism and dedication our nation depends on from warriors of the silent service." Vice Admiral Daryl Caudle, Commander, Submarine Forces, said Vermont's entry to service marks a new phase of American undersea warfare dominance for a global submarine force that's ready to deter, defend, and defeat threats to our nation, allies, and rules-based international order. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why the addition of USS Vermont will significantly improve the U.S. Navy's offensive capability. Let's get into the details. This video is sponsored by War Thunder, the most comprehensive military vehicle online game for PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One, in which you can go to battle on more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s. The game has an amazing attention to detail and focuses on a realistic combat experience, which is why knowing your vehicles and skill really makes a difference. It's easy to get into, and all you need to play is nothing more but your mouse and keyboard or controller. Immerse yourself in cross-platform combat with more than 20 million other military vehicle enthusiasts from all over the world. Download and play War Thunder for free using the link in the description below, and also get a free bonus tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account. The Virginia class, sometimes referred to as SSN 774 class, is a class of nuclear-powered fast attack submarines in service with the United States Navy. Virginia class is designed to replace older Los Angeles class submarines, many of which have already been decommissioned. Virginia class submarines will be acquired through 2043 and are expected to remain in service till 2070. Virginia class submarines are designed for a broad spectrum of open ocean and littoral missions. Their primary purpose is to take out enemy surface combatants and submarines, and the secondary task is to execute land attack missions. Virginia-class submarines were the first U.S. Navy warships designed with the help of computer-aided design, CAD, and visualization technology, CATIA. Each submarine is projected to make 14 to 15 deployments during its 33-year life service. The Virginia-class was intended in part as a less expensive alternative to the Seawolf class submarines, $1.8 billion versus $2.8 billion, whose production run was stopped after just 3 boats had been completed. To reduce costs, the Virginia class submarines use many commercial off-the-shelf COTS components, especially in their computers and data networks. In practice, they actually cost less than $1.8 billion each due to improvements in shipbuilding technology. The Virginia class is built through an industrial arrangement designed to maintain both GD Electric Boat and Newport News Shipbuilding, the only two U.S. shipyards capable of producing nuclear-powered submarines. Under the present arrangement, the Newport News facility builds the stern, habitability, machinery spaces, torpedo room, sail, and bow, while Electric Boat builds the engine room and control room. The facilities alternate work on the reactor plant, as well as the final assembly, test, outfit, and delivery. USS Vermont has been built by shipbuilders General Dynamics Electric Boat in Groton. It has a length of 115 meters. To give viewers a perspective, its length is slightly greater than that of a football field. It displaces about 7,900 tons. USS Vermont, like all other Block 4 subs, is acknowledged to be able to move to depths of 240 meters, or 800 feet, but allegedly capable of going down to 490 meters, or 1,600 feet. A single S9G reactor that produces about 30 megawatts powers Vermont. The reactor features improved corrosion resistance and reduced life cycle costs. It also has reduced size and weight, enabling the submarine to pack more weapons and sensors. The S9G reactor is designed to operate for 33 years without refueling. So, USS Vermont has a practically unlimited range, limited by only food supplies and maintenance requirements. The reactor produces enough power to propel Vermont over 25 knots, that's 46 kilometers per hour, or 29 miles per hour, though the actual numbers may be significantly higher. Block 4 consists of 10 submarines. On the 28th of April 2014, the most costly shipbuilding contract in history was awarded to General Dynamics Electric Boat as the prime contractor. The deal for 10 Block 4 Virginia-class attack submarines was worth $17.6 billion. The main improvement over the Block 3 is the reduction of major maintenance periods from 4 to 3, increasing each ship's total lifetime deployments by 1. So, the Block 4 variant will be capable of a total of 15 deployments. The Virginia class is the first to use photonic sensors instead of traditional periscope. The class is equipped with high-resolution cameras, along with light intensification and infrared sensors, as well as an infrared laser rangefinder. Block 4 variant of Virginia class has redesigned elements and features several types of sonar arrays. 1. It incorporates a large aperture bow, lab, water-backed array, which replaces the traditional air-backed spherical array. This main sonar is one of the most powerful sonars mounted in any of the submarines in the world. 2. Two high-frequency active sonars mounted in the sail and bow. These supplement the main sonar array, improving anti-submarine warfare performance. 3. A fiber optic sonar array consisting of three flat panels is present on either side of the hull. 4. For coverage above and behind the submarine, a high-frequency sonar is mounted on both sides of the submarine sail. USS Vermont is also equipped with a low-frequency towed sonar array and a high-frequency towed sonar array. USS Vermont will be deadly as it's packed with different kinds of weapons to knock out varied targets. 1. Two large-diameter Virginia payload tubes, each capable of launching 6 Tomahawk cruise missiles. Tomahawk is a long-range, all-weather cruise missile that's used for land-based attacks. It has a long range of about 1,000 miles, or around 1,700 kilometers, enabling them to be launched from far off. 2. Four 533mm torpedo tubes for the Mark 48 torpedo. There is a capacity to carry up to 26 Mark 48 torpedoes in the weapons chamber. These torpedoes have a range in excess of 50 kilometers or 31 miles and can be used to take out enemy submarines and surface vessels. 3. Like all Virginia class, Vermont can also lay different types of mines, including Mark 60 Captor encapsulated torpedo mines. 4. An integral lockout lock-in chamber is incorporated into the hull for special operations. The chamber can host a mini submarine, such as Northrop Grumman's Advanced SEALs delivery system, that can be used to transport special warfare forces such as Navy SEAL teams. The main adversaries of the US, Russia and China, are going ahead with the construction of several new subs. Russia plans to build a total of 8 Yasin M-class submarines, which are intended to destroy US aircraft carriers. The latest Kilo-class submarine of the Russian fleet is also a force to take note of. Though Kilo-class is nothing new and has been around in some form or another since the 1980s, the newest 6 submarines of this class represent a significant evolution. Russia is also building the borne class, which will be Russia's new generation of ballistic missile submarines, the cornerstone and most survivable part of its nuclear arsenal. Chinese Navy has been given special attention and is getting a good share of the military budget. It's developing a wide range of conventional as well as nuclear-powered submarines. It's clear that the U.S. Navy needs to be a step ahead, and USS Vermont, being a multi-weapons platform, will significantly improve the offensive capability.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.